Hello, my name is Danny Nolan, I'm the Director of ChassisSim Technologies. When you start to put a vehicle model together, one of the great myths that you see is that putting together a vehicle model is a process that can take months. It's very, very laborious, and it's out of the reach of the hands of most data and race engineers. Well, today, I'm actually going to show you how you can construct a workable vehicle model in a matter of minutes. It's what we at ChassisSim refer to as the ChassisSim 10-minute challenge. That is, in 10 minutes, you can go from basically a blank sheet of paper to a workable model that you can get actually useful results out of. Now, what are the prerequisites for this? Well, the prerequisites are that, first of all, we need to measure up our race car to make sure that we've got the correct springs, motion ratios, and damper settings, ride height settings that pertain to our particular race car. And as you can see, I've already created such a car file, and I've loaded that in. The next bit of data that we need is what we at ChassisSim refer to as the ChassisSim monster file. Basically, we need some appropriate data that matches this setup that basically takes given data from a lap so that we can extract all the information. And we've basically already, now I've already set this up, I've already set this up in this folder here. And as you can see, this is basically what I refer to as my monster file, which is basically all the data from that. Now that we basically got those two bits of information, you're about to see that we can do quite a bit with that. Now, basically, the process we're going to adopt here is going to be actually very, very simple. It's pretty much just a three-step process. The first step is going to be we're going to create an aero map for the car. We're then going to basically use the ChassisSim Tire Force Estimation feature to approximate a tire model. And then what we'll do is we'll load in a circuit and a bump profile we created from this data earlier to basically refine our results. That's it. It's just a three-step process. So, where do we start? Well, the first thing we do is that we basically go to the simulate menu and we go to our aerodynamic modeling. And as you can see, I'm going to click on my monster file import tab and import my monster file. Now here I'm going to say yes, I want to generate aerodynamic coefficients. I'm going to indicate that my dampers have been zeroed on the ground. Once again, my monster file was exported at 50 Hertz, so I'll just put my sampling rate here at 0.02 seconds. And when I'm done, I click on OK. Then I click on the Start button. I click on the Start Simulation tab. And what I've just done here is I've basically just generated a thin sliver of the aero map of what we've just run. Now, as a bit of a sanity check, I'll go through and I'll just do a quick sanity check. So as we can see, the drop-off's a bit extreme here, but basically in the meat here, you can see that there's basically actually quite a bit of an aero sweet spot here. Those numbers look sort of half reasonable. So what I'll do is I'll click on OK. And I'll click on OK, and we're done. Now, to quote the Joker from Batman, now I'm going to show you a little bit of a magic trick. We're going to go back to the Simulate menu, and we're going to go to the Aerodynamic Modeling tab. You're going to see here, I'm going to click on here, the tab called Generate Aero Map from Aero Map Toolbox Results. So I'll just click on here. Now, basically, when I've run the Aero Map Modeling Toolbox, I generate a file called aero_results_analysis.dat in the same directory that I've got my car file in. So what I'm just going to do is I'm just going to click on the aero results file. I'm going to change my file to the star.dat. Lo and behold, that's the aero analysis results I've just generated. I'm going to click on OK. And here, I'm going to click on the tab that says export to current car file. And as we can see, aero map assigned. So what has that done? What that's done is it's just generated an aero map. Let's have a look. Now, as you can see, this error map isn't perfect because we've only had one thin slice of the data to look from. But as you can see here, for something that's only a thin slice, it's actually pretty. It's actually not bad. We can see here. We can see here that when we're in the right height range that we were working in, our results actually look pretty good. Now, as you can note here, in the extremes, I've dropped off here, but that's to be expected because I'm only dealing with one slice of the error map. So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to go through and take a look at basically what my maximum CLA was, which is 3.2. I'll do exactly the same thing for the drag map. And as you can see, I'm going to go to about a value of about 1.308. And what I'll do is I'll now click on my aerodynamic coefficients, and I'm just going to change that to 3.2, and I'm going to change that to 1.31. Now, in reality, when we start building up more of a picture, that arrow map is going to get better. But you can see here that it's actually pretty much on the money for the error results that we've just run. So I'm just going to click on OK. And I'll set the arrow offset to 0. And I'll click on OK. And as I'm going, I'll basically save my car file. And I'll just I'll basically go to File, Save As. And I'll just save that as version 2. So, what I'm now going to do is, now that we've done that, let's now estimate what the tires are going to do. So to do that, we just simply go to the Simulate menu, go down to Tire Force Estimation. We click here to use the Monster Import file, and I simply select my Monster Import, click on OK, and I've just imported my Monster Import file. So, what I'm going to do here is all I need to do now is I've got no strains for this, so I don't need to click here to use tire loads. And as you can see here, because I didn't have strains in the monster file, this is left blank. So all I've got to do here is input my signs. Now here, positive turns for this set of data was actually left-hand turn, so I put in -1. But our steering was positive for right-hand turn, so I leave that for 1. I click here to run the tire force estimation. I click on OK, go to the Simulate menu, and just turn the aerodynamic modeling off. Make sure I've turned that off, which I have. I click on OK. I go to the Start Simulate button. I click on Start Simulate. And as you can see, now we're in the process of generating our tire force estimation. Now, this is a process that's going to take a couple of minutes. So look, go outside, make yourself a coffee, and I'll see you when we come back, and I'll see you when I'm going to talk to you about how you actually import the results that this tire force estimation routine has generated. Okay, welcome back. So we've had our coffee, we've got the tire force estimation run, and here we go. Basically, it's done with our final cost function. Now, what this has just done is it's basically generated two files. Now, basically, the files that it's generated is basically in ChassisSim, the free approximation format. So, and it's been put in the same folder as we had basically our loaded car file. So in our case, that's basically in our ChassisSim video info folder. And lo and behold, I'll just go to view as a list so you can see it a little bit more clearly. Basically, it's basically these two files here. Basically, opt_fnt_tire_file.txt for the front, opt_rear_tire_file.txt for the rear file. So, how do we import that in? Well, that's really simple. We just simply click on the front tire. We go to import v3 ASCII tire file, optimum tire results. We click on here, and we just simply click on optimum front tire file. Click on open, and click on OK. We do exactly the same thing for the rear. Optimum rear tire file, click on open, click on OK. Now, what we've just done is we've basically generated an estimation for the traction circle radius versus load characteristic. Right, Believe it or not, I'll go to save for that. You've just created your car file. It's as simple as that. You have just generated your vehicle model using those two simple processes. Now, the last step in the process is that we need to refine those results. So what we're going to do is we'll go to the circuit menu, and we're just simply going to load in basically a curvature file and a bump profile that I've worked on before. I'll click on OK. Hello, so we've just loaded in our circuit file. We're now ready to basically to run a simulation and see how the lap times compare to our simulated lap. Now, in reality, we'd probably log this to a data logging, but you're going to see that I've already done this previously, but I'm just going to walk you through the process. So this is basically our third step. So we just simply go to, so first things first, we go back to the simulate menu. We make sure the tire force estimation tab is turned off. We click on OK. We go to the start simulation button, and we basically go to start simulation. And as you can see, we're basically going through now and basically running our simulated lap, and we're going to basically log this and compare it to the actual data to see how we are. Now, in reality, we could go through, we could really finesse this up, but just remember, the whole point of the 10-minute challenge is to create a vehicle model as quickly as you can so you can just get over that beginner's hump so that you can see basically what you need to do. So, while it's running here, we're going to take another short break, and I'll see you on the other side for basically what is a simulated lap and basically comparing it to actual data. Welcome back. So, we've completed our simulation, and this is basically our simulated lap time. Let's now compare this to actual data, and we'll see where we're at. So, what we have in front of us is basically a simulated lap compared to our actual lap. Our actual lap is colored, the simulated lap is black. And as you can see, for a first cut, we've done pretty well. First things first, look at what we're looking at down the main straight. The damper traces are just about matching up. But as we can see here, basically, for what has effectively been 10 minutes of work, we're getting pretty good correlation, particularly in this turn. We could probably do a little bit of tweaking on the high speed, but as an overall balance, we're probably doing pretty well, and that's the grand total of about 10 minutes. Now, in reality, I could probably tweak this with a little bit of grip, factor. If I did want to tweak it, I probably might just go to, say, 1.05 grip factor front and 1.05 grip factor at the rear. But to be quite honest, going back to our data here, I'd almost be inclined to leave that, because this now forms the basis of if I'm going to basically use some of the more advanced ChassisSim features like the tire force modeling and aero toolbox to create a bit of a picture. So that as a baseline is pretty good. And just to show you the sort of correlation we're talking, have a look at this. I mean, initial throttle lap is right, our steering lock is okay, our damper traces are pretty, our damper traces are pretty much on the money. Is it perfect? No, it's not perfect. But what we have just done is something much more powerful. We've shown you in the space of approximately 10 minutes how you can get going from a car you've got no idea about to something that you can actually start to use to evaluate setups. And that, my friends, is the power of the ChassisSim 10-minute challenge. But don't take my word for it. Go to the ChassisSim website, request a demo. We'll get you sorted out with a demo, and you can prove this to yourself.